play a cop who, believe it or not, in this fictional world, in the past, somewhere in the past, the kind of FBI, CIA of America has discovered a time travel wake where they can travel around 50 years of the invention of time travel, but that's all. It's a temporal wake. And so what they start doing is sending agents into time to stop certain criminal activities, namely terrorist attacks. And so I play a temporal agent who's traveling through time, who's hunting a terrorist who mysteriously also has the ability to travel time.
So what, you're a cop?
I'm a temporal agent. We prevent crime before it takes place.
What is it?
It's a time machine. Don't ever exceed the jump limit. It can be problematic.
Now, this is actually the second time that you actually worked with Michael and Peter. Mm-hmm. I mean, when they sent you the script, was it an immediate yes, like you wanted to be a part of it? And what was it about it that kind of...
All right, it wasn't an immediate yes, because when I first read the script, I had to stop and immediately read it again. Because it's a very, I found it brilliantly conceived, and I know Robert Heinlein, and I know that he is a card-carrying genius, but I didn't know this story. It's based on a short story by Robert Heinlein called All You Zombies, which is really, it's not about zombies, it's about the fact that all of us are asleep and we're not paying attention to our lives as they pass. So that's cool. But I had to read it a second time to even know what part I was being offered. I didn't even, wait, which temporal agent am I? Where? Is this 1960? Is it 1980? Is it 1952?
At the beginning of your new life, it can be overwhelming knowing the future.
For the film to work, there's a trick to the movie that if a famous actor was playing the other part, it would kind of ruin the reveal. Mm-hmm. And so we knew we needed to find a brilliant unknown actor to play this. And we found Sarah Snook, who gives one of my favorite performances I've ever been involved with. It's a truly just phenomenal performance.
I mean, she's great. She's playing two different characters. I know. I mean, what was your first impression when you first saw the other character that she plays? I mean...
My first impression was that this was a selfish one, which is that this movie's going to work. You know, it, the engine of the movie is her performance. Mm-hmm. And if it didn't work, if she couldn't kind of channel both a deeply feminine self and a deeply masculine self, that, I mean, she's giving a transgender performance in a movie that's not about transgender. Mm-hmm. And I find that revelatory in its own way.
You can do this.
What are you saying? What's that got to do with me?
You're the only one given to the world through a paradox. You must lay the seeds for the future. I know where I come from, but where do all you zombies come from? What if I could put him in front of you? Would you kill him?